Hello friends. So in this video, what we will talk about, if you are someone who has not done mains preparation elaborately, who have no experience of giving mains in the previous attempts and you are new, so this video is to provide you the basics of what is mains all about, what UPSC says about the mains syllabus, what all basic things you need to do to prepare for mains examination, and this will focus on essays and four general studies paper. Okay, optional will be dealt differently through different videos, because for each optional we have to devise important guidelines which will be different, so that will come soon. So first of all, prelims happened, and only one thing I want to tell you, previously also we could not qualify for this examination, but we used to hold a huge amount of respect for this institution, one of the few institutions which was holding a huge amount of respect, and this paper shaken that respect that we hold it with respect to this institution. This is what I wanted to say. So many things are going on in different platforms, but yeah, life is all about moving on. So let's start. First of all, essay paper. Usually what happens, I will tell you the pattern. Usually what happens, on Friday there will be one paper, and that will be of essay. Essay is of 250 marks paper. There are two essays that you have to write, 125 marks, two essays, 125 marks each. Okay, in section A you will get four essays, in section B you will get four essays. Out of four essays in section 1, you have to choose only one essay, and the same you have to do for section B. You cannot write two essays from a single section. These has been done previously by students, so this is one of the basics that you need to learn. Secondly, what is happening in the essay paper is that few of the things you need to ensure before you start writing essays. First of all, the essay preparation, the amount of the knowledge that you need to gain will be built through the preparation of general studies. While you will prepare for general studies 1, 2, 3, 4, it will give you a decent amount of knowledge to write essays. Initially, you cannot start writing essays because you will not have a decent amount of content with you. Secondly, first of all, read what UPSC says about essay paper. UPSC says candidates may be required to write essays on multiple topics. Okay, they will be expected to keep close to the subject of the essay, to arrange their ideas in an orderly fashion, and to write concisely. Credit will be given for effective and exact expression. Now I will break it down for you. First thing what they are telling is keep close to the subject. That means what? Let's take an example of an essay which says that patriarchy is a structural problem in the Indian society. Now, this essay is not talking about patriarchy in general, but patriarchy they are correlating with the structural problem. So, you have to read the topic of essay in toto. Completely, you don't have to write what you know about patriarchy, but what is asked about that topic. Globalization is a boon for elderly, say for example this is asked. So globalization has to be correlated with elderly, and this essay is neither on elderly nor solely on globalization. So the more you will be close to the topic, what happens when you write some 10 pages on essay, after one or two pages you are losing the context. आपसे पूछा ये जाता है और वो ये जाता है कि अब B and C पे चले जाते हो. So keeping your essay closely to the topic of essay is extremely important while writing essay. Second thing what UPSC says. Second thing they say is that idea should be arranged in an orderly fashion. Let's take an example of our human body. Our eyes are on top. Below that there is nose, below that there is lips, and then so forth. So a body is properly arranged in a structured manner. Similarly, essay will be like this. First of all, introduction. In introduction, you can give a bird's eye view. आपने देखा होगा in books you will see prefaces. When you read preface, you get to know that what this book is all about. What this book is all about. A rough idea you get. Similarly, your essay introduction will give a rough idea about what all you will talk about in the essay, so that examiners gets an idea and gets attached to your essay. It should be a bit catchy as well. Secondly, after that, you will try to break down the topic in different fashions. There are several fashions. I will go deep into how it is written and so forth in different videos that will come in the future. But this is the rough idea. So you will write body, and body will be arranged in orderly fashion. Then there will be conclusion. So there should be a orderly arrangement of your ideas. Secondly, what they are telling is credit will be given for effective and exact expression. That means what? In this, it does not mean you have to write like a poet, but your language should be proper. Language should be proper. That means whatever sentence you are writing should not be ambiguous. It should clearly explain the idea. Here the your command and language matters. That does not mean you have to write like Shashi Tharoor. It should be simple only. But here your expression should be exact. Like in GS, what happens? You write 10 points and some of the points are ambiguous in nature and it hardly matters here. But here you have to show the depth of understanding, and for that effective and exact expression. Agar aap bol rahe ho patriarchy ka correlation with the structure of the society, then it should be exactly correlated. This is what UPSC is saying. Iske alawa unhone kuch nahi bola ki aapko map banana, you have to draw map, you have to necessarily write anecdotes, you have to write quotes, you have to write data. This depends on you, what you want to use to make your essay more effective. So you don't have to get distracted ki we have to necessarily make a map or necessarily write an anecdote. Sometimes simple definition in introduction gives a very good look to essay. So this is what essay paper is. Then there are general studies syllabus. And in general studies syllabus, you will see, for example, in GS1, you will see UPSC has written Indian culture will cover the salient aspects of art forms, literature and architecture from ancient to modern times. Then they talk about modern Indian history and freedom struggle. They are also talking about history of the world, capitalism, socialism, etc. Now see how this you have to interpret. Say for example, let's take the example of salient features of Indian society. Now what are the features of Indian society? Let's just break it down. You have to break it down. Salient features will be first the rural nature of Indian society, the endogamy, the caste system, the diversity which is there in the India. Okay, then the patriarchy, everything comes in the salient features of Indian society. The diverse nature mein, lingual diversity, regional diversity. Okay, so everything will be the salient features of the Indian society. So every topic needs to be breakdown. Every word is a keyword, and that you need to understand ki capitalism kya hota hai and what are the contours of capitalism. Phir India ke respect mein, is India a capitalist country? The socialism we are talking about, what is the difference between socialism and capitalism, how it came. So if you will build the basic understanding in each of the GS papers, let's take an example of even GS2 paper. Functions and responsibility of the union and the states, issues and challenges pertaining to the federal structure, devolution of power and finances up to local level and challenges therein. These all are one of the topics which has been given. Like what are the functions of the union? What are the responsibilities of the union government? This is itself a topic. Now how to like go about? In different Telegram channels, you will find so many notes of topics. So many institute notes also you will get. First of all, you need to understand that some amount of hard work you will have to do. You can refer endless amounts of notes, but write in your own language, take A4 sheet, make 4 files and refer any kind of material you want, But write it down, make short notes in your own language, try to understand them. Okay, while you will read and then you will write, you will understand 50% of the things. And keep it precise. If the more bulkier your notes will be, the harder it will become to revise before the mains examination, 10 days, 15 days before the mains examination, and to replicate that in the examination hall. This becomes harder. So you can refer maximum two sources you should keep. Two sources when I am telling is, one aapne governance ke liye maan lijiye, you referred one topper's notes, and one of institute. You know the institute names, so usme se kuch bhi aapne refer kar liya. And do use Google, because Google mein everything is available, everything. You just type it and you will get so many resources. So resources ka issue nahi hai. But covering each and every contour, writing in your own words will help you. If you have time crunch, you are a working professional, then the matter is different. You can rely on one compilation or one thing because you don't have time. So then you can rely on things. But you need to understand that here UPSC plays with the syllabus. 1 year, what they will do, they will ask 50 marks art and culture question. In modern history, they will ask only one question. In some year, they will ask two world history questions. In some year, they will ask zero question. So covering each and every topic is extremely important. If you will leave any topic and your luck is not good, that year what will happen, they will ask some 3, 4, 5 questions on that paper. So inclusivity is important, not the depth, not going too deep into one topic. Sabko samajhna hai, sabko ijjat deni hai. And then there is a different subject altogether, it is ethics. And ethics knowledge is correlated to essay. How ethics is different? First of all, ethics, if you are cramming, like accountability kya hota, if you are cramming simply the definition, what UPSC is doing is, they are not asking what is accountability. They will give you some question where the knowledge you have gained about accountability will be applied. So they are asking applied kind of question. So isme to understand the keywords, the nuances is very important. Isme simple cramming will not work. So whatever notes you are choosing, first of all, see the language is comfortable for you or not. Don't just go behind the notes or the topper's notes like they have got 160 marks or 170. See where you are comfortable with. See where you think you can correlate, you can understand. Or any video lectures if you think you are comfortable with, you can refer them. Understanding is very, very important in ethics. Once you cover all these nuances, one horoscope of UPSC examination is previous year questions. The first practice that you have to do is of previous year questions. After covering all this, say for example, you have finished GS1, just start writing PYQs. If you can get evaluated, you can get a peer review. It is very good. Also, you can read your answers yourself also. This also helps a lot. You will definitely not like your first answer. A good answer is written on the heap of thousands of bad answers. It does not happen that the first answer will be very good. We all struggle to write our first answers. Even the rank one struggled, and it is quite obvious that this mains preparation demands a lot of hard work, and you will need to do a lot of physical work. You need to write a lot. You will feel frustrated initially. You will not have content. But if you will go like this, covering all the keywords, covering all the parts of syllabus, making 4 files, using A4 size papers, covering the static part of this, the syllabus, and then this applied part like current affair, etc. And that is also more important for GS2 and GS3. GS1, GS4 is per se more or less a static kind of paper. Okay, so cover first the basics and static information. Download this, this syllabus of UPSC. Go through it, read them. Even when you will write answers, these keywords which are given will help you to write answers. This I will teach you in further videos how they help. But this is the basic idea about the mains examination. 1000 marks GS, each paper 250, 250 essay, 1250 marks, and apart from that, there is optional. And to get a good rank, you need to cover each of the subject in a comprehensive manner, because even a single paper can destroy your chances to qualify mains and get a good rank. So I hope this introductory video on how to start for mains will help you. Thank you. Best of luck. Take care.